We've already done all the hard work of creating our animation with our update function, including things like filtering our data, removing and adding any new elements that need to be placed on the page, as well as dealing with the data bind and key function, which determine which elements to add or remove. D3 has great support for built-in transitions, and all you need to do to make the transition smooth is use D3's special built-in functions, one of which is transition, which kicks off a transition, and the second most used is the duration. In this case, we make our selection, we append anything that needs to be appended, and then kick off a transition that takes 500 milliseconds. And what actually changes during the transition? Well, that's what comes after it. All of these attributes, which move the circles and set their radius, take 500 milliseconds to complete and operate on the enter selection and the circles we are appending. So now when we're adding circles, they'll transition more smoothly, but also, potentially more importantly, we want the countries to transition smoothly. So following the exact same syntax, we place transition with a duration of 500 milliseconds right before we change the fill and the stroke of countries to update and hide or show based on the year of the World Cup. I would say this is one reason to use D3's built-in style functions to add style to our elements rather than using CSS, so we can have much more flexibility in how we animate and apply those styles. As you can see here, the countries transition out and in much smoother than they did before, since we added the transition to the styles applied to the countries, as well as the circles as they come in and get placed at their respective home country they belong on top of. And now that we've finished our map, or at least the animation of it, we can start to see a little story unfolding. Can you find a narrative in the graphic we've created?